Well, it uses an artificial intelligence system that was trained using deep neural networks on 375,000 diabetic images. So basically you put in, you know, this is a patient whose eye has, say, mild non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy or moderate or severe. These are different levels that we use, or proliferative diabetic retinopathy, and you train the system. This is deep learning. It was then tested on another 175,000 plus images to see how accurate it was. And then once that testing was done, we then said, okay, it's ready for use now in a clinical trial. So in the clinical trial, we compared it to the gold standard of these fundus photographs that were read by the Wisconsin Fundus Photograph Reading Center. So specifically what we did is we took two pictures without the patient being dilated, and these are of a certain size. They're 45 degree images. One is centered on the optic nerve, the other is centered on the macula, so two per eye. And then afterwards, we allowed the EyeArt system to interpret the image and say, is there or is there not this referable level of diabetic retinopathy? So it had to hit moderate NPDR specifically, or there had to be swelling of the retina, diabetic macular edema. If for some reason the EyeArt system could not read those images, then the patient underwent dilation and these images were repeated, sent again to the EyeArt system, and then, you know, to see if it could read it. After that, the patient underwent dilation if they hadn't already been dilated, and that was the vast majority, because the vast majority were readable. So after dilation, they then underwent 45 degree wide field images, four fields per eye. And these four images are equivalent to the standard seven-field ETDRS photographs, which have been used in multiple diabetic retinopathy staging studies. And we then compared the presence of moderate NPDR or CSDME between the two methods, the EyeArt system and the Wisconsin Fundus Photograph Reading Center results.